بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His servant and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As to what follows, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, do you know the blessed month of Ramadan, of course, is the month of the Quran, it's the month of dua. And if you were to ponder over the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yani in the authentic books of hadith, they collect and they recall and they mention many dua that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make in his life. And the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were all full of khushu', and they were all full of words of humility and humbleness. And his dua was full of request and begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually stands out in the way he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for one thing in his life. This dua is very unique, even يعني, to the point where at the end of this dua, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says to the companions that the one who has memorized and has learned this dua, you must teach it to others. That's how the ending of the dua is. This is how great it is. You're going to find out that this dua is very unique and stands out in the way Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Serious humility is involved in this hadith. Serious humbleness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is actually begging for one thing. And the entire beginning of the dua is just an introduction to one thing he wanted sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the way that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks for it, obviously it teaches us that this is a dua, it must be in your life. You must include this dua in your life, especially as we're ending Ramadan. Yani it is good to include it in the dua list of yours. So this hadith, it begins by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Allahumma inni abduka wa abnu abdika wa abnu amatik. Very special beginning. He says, Oh Allah, inni abduk, I am your slave, the son of your slave, the son of your female slave. Allahumma inni abduka wabnu abdika wabnu amatik. It's as though someone is holding onto the Kaaba and he's begging, or someone smothering his face in the dua and begging and saying, Oh Allah, I am your slave and my whole generation is enslaved to you. And I've never tasted freedom in my life. And I only know slavery to you. And I am the most humbled of creation before you. I am in full submission and obedience to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inni abduka wa abnu abdika wa abnu amatik. It's like this person is saying, I am your slave in all cases. Whether I'm obedient to you, I'm your slave. Even in moments I disobey you, I acknowledge that I'm still your slave. Whether I'm young or I'm grown up, I'm still abduk, I am enslaved to you. Whether I'm alive or I'm dead, I'm still your abd. In the good conditions that I live, and otherwise, I am all yours. My wealth, myself, my children, and everything I own is all for you. Allahumma inni abduk. Look at this dua, how it begins. Full of humility, I tell you. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Now siyati biyadik. My forelock is in your hand. In other words, you have total control of me. I don't even own myself. I don't even own my mind. This is in your hand and you control it the way you want. Now, siyati biyadik. Maldin fiya hukmuk, adlun fiya qada'uk. You can judge me the way you want. Maldin fiya hukmuk, you judge me the way you want. I won't complain because adlun fiya qada'uk. Your judgment is always just and it's fair and it's upright. Adlun fiya qada'uk. Yani, subhanAllah, how much humility already. And the request hasn't even started yet. And it still goes on. What is the thing that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants for such an introduction? So then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, As'aluka bi kulli ismin huwa lak. Oh Allah, I ask you by every single name that is yours. How many names are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? More than 99 names. Allah azza wa jal, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah azza wa jal mentions in the Quran, وَلَوَ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٌ وَالْبَحْرُ يَمُدُّهُ من بعده سبعة أبحر ما نفذت كلمات الله. The names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you were to gather all the oceans and the oceans were to be ink and all the trees on earth were to be pencils and you were to dip them in the ocean and begin to write the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the oceans would finish and the trees would finish and the words of Allah would not finish. أسألك بكل اسم هو لك, I ask you by every single name that belongs to you. Yani in this one part, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is saying, Ya Alim, Ya Qadir, Ya Hakim, Ya Khaliq, Ya Allah, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. All of the names of Allah are included in this. Like the names of Allah Azza wa Jal are three types. They mention, أَنْزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ أَوْ أَنْزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ. The names that belong to Allah, I ask you, by that which was revealed in your book, أَسْأَلُكَ بِكُلِّ اسْمٍ هُوَ لَكَ سَمَّيْتَ بِهِ نَفْسَكَ, that you named yourself with. أَوْ أَنْزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ, you revealed in your book, in the Qur'an. أَوْ عَلَّمْتَهُ أَحَدًا مِّنْ خَلْقِكَ, عَلَّمْتَهُ أَحَدًا مِّنْ خَلْقِكَ, you taught one of your creation, you taught one of your creation, you know, like the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the day of judgment, Allah Azza wa Jal teaches him names of him subhanahu wa ta'ala that he never used to know in this life. أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك, or you kept unknown to us. You kept unknown. There are names of Allah Azza wa Jal that only Allah knows and no one knows. This great dua, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is asking Allah through all these names that belong to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I ask you with all your names, whether they are known to me or they're not known to me. This is the beginning of dua. Now, what is your request, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What is this request of yours? He makes the request and he says, أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلبي ونور صدري وجلاء حزني وذهاب همي وغمي. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that you make the Quran, I'm going to focus on this word, ربيع قلبي, but for now, the spring of my heart. Make the Qur'an the spring of my heart. Then the entire dua is just about the Qur'an itself. The entire introduction and this begging and this full of humility and humbleness is just so that Allah Azza wa Jal allows this Qur'an to penetrate into the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the importance of the Qur'an. If this Qur'an was to enter the heart, khalas, life changes. And if it's missing in the heart, life is disaster. أن تجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي ونور صدري, make it the spring and the joy and the delight of my heart and the light of my chest, fill my chest with light of the Quran and the remover of my sadness and the abolisher of my worries. Allahumma ij'al al-Quran rabi'a qalbi, make the Quran the spring of my heart. What does this mean? What does rabi'a qalbi mean? It implies two things. Number one, rabi'a qalbi, they used to say يعني الربيع, they say هو الربيع هو الجدول المائي. This is what الربيع is in Arabic. الجدول المائي, meaning the channels in which the water flows, and then as a result it reaches the land and it irrigates the land. So اجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي, meaning oh Allah, allow this Quran to channel through my ears as I hear it, and allow it to get to my heart, and as a result allow it to irrigate my heart. Right? اجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي. Allow it to flow straight in until it reaches the heart, and then it gives life to the heart, because when water reaches land, it gives life to the land. So allow the Quran to irrigate my heart and give it life. And the other meaning of ربيع قلبي, they say ربيع, it comes from the word ربع, يتربع. والتربع is to sit the way you're sitting, folded, when you fold your legs and you sit, that is التربيع. So اجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي, you know, when one sits and he's folding his legs, what does that imply? It implies he's going to sit for a while, he's going to sit there and he's not moving anytime soon. So اجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي, meaning allow it to settle firm in my heart, and make it settle in my heart, and give me يعني steadfastness on this Quran, and keep it in my heart so that it doesn't go anywhere, right? That is, أن تجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي. What an incredible dua. يعني if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was to accept this one dua, this Quran, if it was to be in the heart, it'll cleanse and it'll purify it from the dirt and from the sins and from the bad and filthy habits that it does. والقرآن, يعني if it fills, يعني if it was to fill the chest with light and guidance, يعني as a result, the worries, as the hadith mentions towards the end, the worries, the sadness, the depression, the anxiety, the sorrows of life, all goes away. Only what remains within is the genuine pure fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a great dua, my brothers and sisters in Islam. This is why at the end of the hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the companions, when they heard this hadith, they said, Ya Rasulullah, yanbaghi lana an nata'allama hadhihi al-kalimat. Should we learn this dua? Should we learn it? For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ajal, definitely. Yanbaghi liman sami'ahunna an yata'allamahun. Yanbaghi, yani, it is almost necessary for the one who hears it that he should learn it. And if you were to learn it, as a result, you use it in your life and you continuously make this hadith and make this dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One thing we learn from this hadith, my brothers and sisters in Islam, that Al-Quran isn't given to anyone. Al-Quran, it doesn't enter the hearts of anyone. Allah Azza wa Jal chooses people for this. ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. Allah Azza wa Jal, when he spoke about inheriting this Quran to servants of his, he mentioned اصْطَفَيْنَا, people that we chose because of their purity. Al-Istifa comes from the word al-Istifa' safi, something that is pure. Look at the dua of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is teaching us that in order for this Quran to be a part of your life, you need to display absolute humility and display absolute humbleness to Allah Azza wa Jal, that you are really in need of this Quran. You're supposed to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow the Quran and its meanings to penetrate in your heart and become rabi'a of your heart, that it settles in there firm. And the other thing is that it irrigates this heart and it gives it life. Inshallah ta'ala, today if you're subscribed to the WhatsApp service, we're going to send this hadith across so that inshallah ta'ala you receive it and you make the most of the end of these blessed days of Ramadan, in that you make plenty of this dua in your life. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the Quran rabi'a qulubina wa nur sudurina wa jala'a ahzanina wa dhahaba humumina. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. We'll be right back.